Welcome back to the channel. For those of you that have been following, this is my big turbo 1 series with the N54 engine. If you remember, or if you don't, this one has the 013 big single, forward facing manifold, PR coils, and an 8-speed transmission. It's still rear wheel. I didn't do anything crazy like an all-wheel drive setup. Some of you are wondering why we don't have an update video yet. I have tried to turn it up, but the car has been kind of pushing back a little bit. First thing we ended up having to deal with was the EKPM, so the fuel pump controller. We turned it up a bit, and for whatever reason, the fuel pump was, or the fuel pressure was sticking at a certain PSI. EKPM was overheating, so when you restarted, it would be fine. So that has an upgraded unit. In tank, we have a Walbro 450, and we tried to turn it up, and same thing. It was having some sort of a crashing issue above 6,200 RPM. And the high pressure pump was crashing. I did finally wire in the port controller. I did learn that eventually you will start cavitating the high pressure pump above a certain boost and above a certain power level or power figure. So with the port controller, it's all installed, wired up, just inside the DME box right here. Now, I took it for a test drive, port's not spraying. So I had to do a little more diagnosis and diagnosing. I made sure I was running the proper back end flash. And going back and forth with Terry from BMS, we ended up finding out that it was likely the chip was outdated. So it has the one chip. I'm gonna show you kind of what you're dealing with here, and I will put a link in the description for those of you that may run into this issue. This vehicle here had a JB4, so it does have a G5 ISO from way back when, so it didn't have the updated chip. I did install the chip, and now's the time where we're gonna take it for a bit of a drive and see if it works. We're gonna be looking to make sure that the low pressure is spot on and also see if we can keep a little bit of traction. It's the few days before the long weekend, so I'm trying to find a relatively quiet spot to do a quick log. So just over here, you'll see there's WMI flow. This is what we're looking. If this is anything above zero and, well, I guess under 99, then we're in good shape and the meth is spraying. So let's see if I can do a quick log here and go from there. I did not see, so let's over somewhere where I can take a look at the log quick. No codes. Let's check. Oh, we'll go this way. Oh, you know what? One thing I noticed is I left traction control on. I'm gonna press it one click and I'm gonna have to re-log. It felt okay, but let's see. Okay. Okay, so it's probably a good thing I had DTC 1 press because I just fried through tires. And I still didn't even check to see what meth was spraying. So let's maybe do a quick loop, let it slow down, cool down, and I'm gonna check. I didn't check to see if it was spraying at all. So we're gonna go around the block really quick. And I'm gonna check on the log. Of course, you guys would have seen it. I didn't, so feel free to let me know. Do we have port running or is it not running? All right, just shut the vehicle off so it can cool down. Let's open the last log. And boost is, it's a little bit laggy for whatever reason, I'm not sure. That seems to be trimming up to 16 roughly. Oh, wait a minute. What are meth? Okay, so it looks like port's actually working. And ignition is 0. But you can see here, I'm gonna use my fancy, not so fancy stylus. But right through here, you can see where it's actually starting to spin. So the timing drops off. So let's do right here. So you can see where it starts to blow the tires off at about 5,500. And the next one over, timing is zero. So what it's doing is it's kicking in traction control because I only had DTC one press. Low pressure looks good. So if you want to keep an eye on these two, 11 and 26, 10, 12. So fuel pressure looks good. And then it looks like port spraying. The boost is a little bit all over the place, but you can see there's one right here where it started to spin and one big one right there where it started to spin. So what did it do? Yeah, air fuel looks good right here. It jumps from 11.4 to 12.3. It's doing what it needs to do. That's awesome. So I'm not quite sure what to do. In the log where I kind of pointed it out, the tires are getting a little bit angry with me. They're spinning, they're blown off, and even with the rear tires aired out to 20-22 PSI, they're still not holding. To get an accurate log, you would definitely need to hold DTC for a few seconds so that you're gonna have traction control fully off. In the meantime, I can't get a proper log and it probably won't trim properly. Good thing is the port injection is working. Bad thing is we don't have traction. So I definitely wanna turn it up and see what it can do. But what that leads me to believe is my next step is hopping on Marketplace and looking for sticky tires. And I'm really kicking myself this time for selling the Mickey Thompsons with my old E90. Yep, that was dumb, but I also didn't think I'd have another N54, let alone a BMW bolt pattern. So, yay, we gotta spend more money. All right, so I've been scouring Facebook Marketplace, and after a failed attempt at a set of wheels, which are these ones, so similar to the M4 style, those didn't work out. They were 17 by 8 with a 35 offset, and when I put the tire on, it didn't fit. Yeah, well, those are technically the tires, but ignore that. I went a completely different route, and now I have too many things hanging around. So what I did get is a set of wheels off an X3 with a 46 offset, and I ended up putting the exact same Nanking NS2R tires onto it. So these are 255 4017 tire. So these ones here should do pretty good. I believe these ones are 180 tread rating, so they should be more than sticky and provide me the traction that I need. So the plan of attack is I'm gonna clean up the bore because it looks like it sat at the bottom of a lake, and find some center caps and throw them on. And there we have it. The wheels are installed with a little bit of a snap of the fingers and magic, and my poor weathered knees cracking. They seem to fit pretty good. We ended up putting a few blocks of wood underneath the tire and then loaded it up with Chad being a ballast, and they seem to clear. So I'm gonna lower the pressure to about 30-32 PSI and take it out and see how they do.
The next day.
Well, ladies and gents, as you saw in the last clip, I ended up installing some sticky tires and figured they would work out pretty good. Nope, they did not fit. I took it around the block, I hit a moderate bump, and right away it ended up rubbing on the quarter panel. So right inside here, there's a chunk of metal. So it is semi-rolled, but this chunk of metal there, you would either have to cut it out, roll it. I really don't feel like screwing up with, not screwing up, but I really don't feel like screwing with a really clean body on a vehicle. If it had chips and whatever else, it wouldn't be a big deal, but I don't feel like rolling them. So the tires are sitting here. I'm going to list them. I think I had all of maybe 10 kilometers on them. So I don't feel like swapping them from wheels to wheels. So they're initially on those wheels, and then I got those as a spare, and those were meant for this. And so they're a 17 by 8 with a 46 offset, and yeah, no dice. So fitting sticky tires on a 1 series, I'm learning, is a huge pin in the backside. So what I ended up doing is I took the air out of the factory, well, not the factory, the wheels that were on the vehicle. So those are 18 by 9.5 something work wheels with a 255. Should be okay, but I did end up lowering them to 20 PSI. We had a cold snap, fired up the vehicle, and yep, the engine cover's off, so I had to start playing with that. In perfect N54 wisdom, I had an awful misfire that would not go away. And lo and behold, yep, one of the, yeah, it still smells like raw fuel. I don't know if it's gonna show you the tip here. Let me zoom in and see if it's gonna show you. It's extremely plugged up and I cannot believe how bad it is. So what I ended up doing is I changed this coil and the misfire went away. I put the engine cover back on, that sad thing over there. And as soon as I put the engine cover back on, it started to misfire differently. Now, what was really weird is it started to misfire in a really weird way. So I took the engine cover off, went away, put it back on. So it must be something to do with the PRs. I snugged all the 10 mil bolts down and it seemed to be good, but a weird misfire. And again, it was only at idle, so I couldn't figure it out. But it kept throwing cylinder 5 misfire. Same cylinder that I ended up changing the injector on. Of course, spark plug. It is unbelievably fouled for having only a couple thousand kilometers. So while I was diagnosing that misfire, I decided to just keep the engine cover off, and sure enough, spark plug was bad. I had a handful, like any other N54. We had a handful of used plugs, gapped it down to 24 thou, threw it in, and it seems okay, but I haven't cold started it since. So actually, let's fire it up while I have you guys here. All right, N54, are you gonna behave with me? So far it seems okay. A little hiccup here and there on a cold, when you don't get rid of the cold start, idle, reduction, whatever, it's fine. But usually when it came off idle, it started to miss. So let's take a listen. Seems okay. I'm gonna let it warm up, get to temp, give it a couple of revs, shut the hood and see if we get traction. Well, I got to my appointment here at good old Chinook Mall. I went to go take off to head back home. Everything was great. I didn't have any issues with the car. And lo and behold, it started misfiring on a warm start now. So what I'm doing is I'm just giving it a once over. There's a bunch of dust and dirt and whatever in there. I don't see anything super obvious. I don't know what the hell that's from. So long story short, I'm gonna put a screen cap up. If you guys pay attention to cylinder 5, we've already changed everything on cylinder 5. We've changed the plug, we've changed the coil, we've changed both wires, both the blue spark plug lead, whatever you wanna call it, and the signal one, and it still misfires. And I'm not sure why. So it's perfectly fine on a cold start, no misfires, and I've monitored it with Pro Tools, but for whatever reason, on a hot start, misfires. Yeah, so that's a bit of an update as to what I'm dealing with now. So I have to let it cool down a fair bit until it's stone cold to be able to start it without a misfire and go from there. So I'm not sure. It might be the used injector I had put in. It was confirmed good in my other N54. With the E90, but when it gets hot, maybe it starts dripping. I'm gonna sit here for a bit, sipping on my concoction I have at Tim Hortons of 3 milk, 2 sugar, espresso shot, and a vanilla flavor shot. N54 things. Welcome back. I guess this is gonna be update 473 and a half. One series, Hood open, again, as always. We ended up running into an issue, so you saw when I took it for a spin. For whatever reason, on a hot start, it was misfiring. But again, it looks complete. So fortunately enough, I have a few engines sitting around. Now, this one here is the original engine that was out of the vehicle. What we ended up doing is we took these brackets off, we pulled these two injectors. It wasn't great, so I think we ended up using 5. Yeah, we used injector 5, so it's an index 5. And the disaster that we ended up running into was, I don't know where the injectors are, those two injectors and this one in the box, they're all crap. They sat on the shelf from my E90 and they were perfectly fine then, but they're not perfectly fine now. Bit of a rundown is, initially it had an issue with a cold start where it would misfire and then clean up. One of those is the injector, I don't remember. The second one, it was seemingly fine, but it was misfiring on cylinder 4. So I figured, okay, I have extra injectors, let's swap it. So I swapped injector 4 and it's been mint, but then I noticed 5 had an issue still on a hot start. Weird. So I changed it again to this one, an index 7, and to make sure that I don't mess it up because I have way too many, I put it in and ironically, it flooded the motor excessively and to the point where it hydrolocked. Now, if you know about hydrolocking, it's a huge issue. Can't compress fuel like you can't compress water, and it shut the motor off. So I pulled a plug, I checked it, it was soaked in gas. I held the lighter to it and the spark plug lit up like a Roman candle. That's from my Oryx 7 days. Generally, if it ended up being flooded, you would pull the plug, hold the lighter to it, let it burn off all the gas and then throw it back in. So I did that and waited until it evaporated and then put in cylinder 5 injector number 3 or 4, I don't know, I haven't paid attention. So it does have a new injector. I did start it yesterday. It did not misfire. There was one count of misfire on cylinder 6. I'm gonna treat that like a freak whatever, but I am super happy that I decided to buy a 25 pack of injector seals. So this little cap to compress the seal onto the injector, you just use a lid off a Bic pen and let it sit for a bit. So hopefully this is the last time, knock on wood, that I need to do it. But essentially you get something like this where it gradually gets bigger. You push the seal over there to stretch it a hair and then you pop it onto the injector. You let it naturally constrict, and then when it's naturally constricted, you toss one of these over top, give it 20 minutes, half hour for it to constrict further and to compress the seal, and then you put it into the injector bore. So this is gonna be round 5 of test driving. I again have the tires aired out, so I'm going to take it out for a spin. It is a bit cooler out. I'm not expecting it to have traction, but I wanna make sure that the injector is good and that we're not gonna have any issues moving forward. See how it goes. So I stopped to make sure that the car wasn't having any issues, that it wasn't leaking fuel, and didn't really find anything to worry about. Smells like a bit of heat wrap, but that's kind of whatever. Yeah, I did end up noticing that there was a little bit of sweating coming from the oil filler cap, which is weird. I don't know, maybe the one I got, it's just not sealing well enough, but sometimes you can just bend the tabs and you'll be good to go. Let's see if it misfires. Fix. Thank you. So far so good. I'm gonna drive around a little bit more so it warms up just a hair more. It is a bit cooler today. I don't know exactly what the ambient temperature is, but it's somewhere between cold and moderate. Not sure why it's idling a bit higher either. That's bit strange. I did notice that the last time, that when it idles a bit higher, it's because there was a misfire. So far, it's sounding all right. Man, I'm cooking myself. It hasn't misfired. I've gone above a few thousand RPM. I'm hoping that's dust behind us and not some type of smoke. This looks pretty good. Come on, car, behave yourself. I think we're good. And we had a bit of traction, which was nice. Okay. I'm gonna pull over to the side here, throw in some hazards. Oh, that's a door unlock. Let's go in park, e-brake. Let's take a gander. Clean. Okay. So, let's go to map 2. Huh. And give that a shot. Okay, now, bear in mind, traction is going to be pretty limited, and I do have the traction control off, but the tires are aired out quite a bit to the point where they may cause some additional drag. We'll use this piece of road good enough. It's a bit dusty, but I think it'll be okay. I know regardless I'm going to be blowing the tire. I don't like it. Oh, my speedo's not working. Oh no. That pothole killed my speedo? No, come on. What? I just want to park this thing for winter. Like, I went from zero issues to headache. You know what? People, get out of the way. I've got a lot to do. So I had to feather a little bit, but it just blew the tires off in third. It is what it is. So I'm gonna head back. If you guys wanna take a gander at this, yeah, you can see I just cooked them and then I rolled off the throttle and yeah, the boost went down. I mean, what do you expect when you're just blowing off tires? But needless to say, traction is an issue, and it's going to be a next year problem. Maybe we'll do one more. That was kind of fun. Oh, yeah. Just blows the tires off, but man. Oh, okay. At whatever boost it's running, it feels really good and really strong. There you have it. The reason why I haven't turned up, or I guess can't turn up my 1 series, not quite yet. Biggest factor, if you haven't figured out, is just dumb little problems as soon as I started to play with the injectors. So that's fortunately all sorted for the most part. Other than that, it's just the weather. We're in good old Canada. It is what, October 24th? It's maybe 4 degrees outside. You're not putting any sort of power down with the cold temperatures and the cold asphalt or tarmac pavement, whatever. It does look pretty good though. Just sitting there in front of all the junk I'm trying to clean. I'm gonna focus on cleaning up this mess so we can bring you some winter projects and hopefully start on the red one sooner than later. I would really like to do that. Yeah, I'm gonna focus on cleaning the garage, but you will see the 1 series out this winter. We do have some fun things planned for it. I do have up top there. Am I pointing at it? I can't see if I'm pointing at it. But we do have the roof rack with the roof basket, and we do have some pretty aggressive winter tires. So that'll be all for this one. As always, feel free to like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys on the next one. I need you to behave. Please. Wait, I know. Fix. Nope. Okay.